Alright, so before any of you guys try to tell me that it's been 2 weeks since I've done a video, I've been very busy with very legitimate stuff, so don't even try to at me about that. But I'm here now to go ahead and cover how powerful Bodhgan Luisenbarn is, and you guys know the drill for all the intro stuff. I have my Discord linked in the description, go ahead and hit that link up. There's also the poll for the next Fate video in the top right hand corner. I'm going ahead and redoing the Archer class poll because we had a few odd results that came in with like Gilgamesh taking first place and everybody tying for second place, and that would just mean the Fate video is coming too quick because I do like to space them out between the Bleach videos. So I'm redoing it and I'm adding in like Fate Grand Order and Fate extra characters as well because you guys seem to really want me to add those characters in there. I didn't know that they were so popular. So I've added those guys in there. Go ahead and vote. It's in the top right hand corner. Anyway, let's go ahead and get right into this video. So let's go ahead and open up by saying that Bodhgan isn't star level. I'll see a lot of people try to wank him and say that, oh, he said that even stars can age, so therefore Bodhgan can be star level, right? And it's like, no, this is the same issue you see with Dongai Ichigo and Aizen being higher dimensions, because people are like, oh, I see dimension, the word dimension, and that's referenced in versus debating, so therefore it must correlate with the versus algorithm. And I'm like, no, it's not like that at all, dude. You're taking the word star out of context to pretty much suit your needs of him being star level, when if you read the actual context of what Bodhgan's saying, he's just talking about how aging is sort of an absolute ability and that everything eventually ages and dies. However, there's still those people that say, well, if you put Bodhgan next to a star, he can age it, you know, he would eventually take it out, so he's like star level over time. And you can also debunk that pretty easily by just kind of bringing up Yamamoto, because Yamamoto's Bankai literally is the sun, and Yamamoto would absolutely clap Bodhgan. So no, you can't even just like throw him next to the sun and be like, oh, he'd age it over time. It's like, nah, we already have characters in Bleach that are literally the sun who would clap Bodhgan. Now, to actually find out how powerful Bodhgan is, it does kind of depend on how much stronger you think he is over Holly Bell and Ukiyora, and in the first place, how strong you think someone like Ukiyora is. But if you're trying to stay as objective as possible and you say that Ukiyora in his first resurrection is only small country level, and his Segunda Etapa is 10 times that, and his Segunda Etapa is still somewhat weaker than resurrected Holly Bell, we don't exactly have an objective number on that. And then that Holly Bell is actually weaker than resurrected Bodhgan by some amount, you would just have Bodhgan being like vaguely above this guy who's like 10 times small country level, which I get isn't a very fun answer, but if I'm trying to stay as objective as possible and not, you know, quote unquote calc stack, that's the result you would get. Now, if you're scaling off of other characters like resurrected Grimmjow, who's actually relative to his Gran Rey Seto, and you scale that up to Bodhgan, you would have Bodhgan actually coming out to be more like Continental Plus, again, depending on, you know, the numbers you're using to show differences between characters. There's some of them, but like Noitor and Grimmjow, that you can kind of find it. Okay, base Noitor is about the same strength as resurrected Grimmjow, and we know resurrection is at least a 5 to 10 times increase. So some of those you can use objective numbers that we have, and you can scale pretty accurately. But there are a lot of characters in the series that it's really hard to figure out like what the exact gap is between them. Like for instance, Segunda Etapa, Ukiyora, and Holly Bell. We don't know the exact gap between the two, so it can get a little dicey at times. As far as speed is concerned, you can do one of two things. The first thing is just say that he's like massively hypersonic, and that, you know, we even know that Bankai Ichigo in the Soul Society arc was a lightning timer, and this Bodhgan is way stronger and far superior to that Bankai Ichigo, so objectively you can say that he's at least like massively hypersonic plus. The other thing you could try to do is get Bodhgan to light speed by saying he's somewhat relative to the Sternritter, since even Latato is able to dodge the Ashwalin, which is stated to be light on multiple occasions. The problem is that Bodhgan, Holly Bell, and even Ukiyora don't really have anything that puts them on the Sternritter level, because even Bodhgan got damaged by Soifone's Bankai pretty badly. Like, he himself admits that he got badly damaged by this pre-timeskip Soifone, who's way weaker than even the Sternritters that beat the snot out of her in, like, post-timeskip. So it's really hard to get these guys to being on the Sternritter tier. With Stark and Yami, it is possible, but we'll get into that in their videos. So, moving on to Bodhgan's abilities, he of course does have the standard Arrancar abilities like Acero, Sonido, Pesquisa, Hierro, all that good stuff. But Bodhgan's abilities, like the things that are unique to him, is that he controls aging and time. Like, that's what his whole shtick is. For instance, even before Bodagon goes into his resurrection, he's able to age Soifon's bones in her arm to where it just becomes completely useless to her, and is even able to age her movements or slow her down, basically. Like, as she's going to kick Bodagon, he's able to slow her down pretty much to a dead stop and then just, like, chuck her into a building or whatever. So, even before he goes into his resurrection, he's already got this grasp over time or aging per se. It's more aging. It's not like he's fourth dimensional or anything and he's like way above time. Don't misunderstand me there. Then when Bodagon goes into his resurrection, he gains the Respira, which is pretty much just this wave of death, because whatever it touches, it ages and that just completely dies. For instance, Soifon's arm just barely nicks the Respira and it just starts aging her entire arm to where she had to get it cut off or she would have died. And that should be noted also that it's not just this slow, like, ominous wave that's coming at you. It's like, no, this is pretty quick, and Bodagon even implies that he can control the speed by saying that when he's chasing Mauricio around, you know, Almeida, he's purposefully slowing down the Respira, so he kind of makes it more fun for him. But it should be noted that he was able to catch up to Soifon of all people, who's one of the fastest Shinigami, so this ability is really, really OP. Now, the Respira isn't the most absolute ability out there. I know a lot of people seem to think it's really dumb OP, but do keep in mind that if you're capable of creating barriers, you can slow the Respira down, like Hachi did with his Kido barriers. And also, say if you're a lot faster than Bodagon is, you'll be able to dodge the Respira. So don't go out there with Bodagon thinking he's just gonna slap any character out there that's capable of aging. But that's all that I have for you guys. If you enjoyed, please leave a like and subscribe. Next video we'll be covering Stark. Don't forget to vote on the Fate poll in the top right hand corner, and don't forget to go hit up the Discord linked below. With that being said, I'm gonna go ahead and get out of here. You guys have yourselves a nice day. Peace, late guys.